Hi everyone, I'm going to lead you in a gentle heart opener sequence, a restorative sequence. So you can start with a blanket under your knees if you want some extra support there. Grab your bolster. We're going to come into Tadpole, also known as our child's pose. So you bring your knees wide, your feet together. If you need some extra support, you can prop up some blankets and things underneath, just over the heels and between the thighs. Otherwise, you just come straight down onto your bolster. We'll lie flat, draw that bolster in so you've got lots of support. And we're going to rest the head to one side. We're going to really sink and use our props today. Soften the shoulders. Just allow the arms to bend gently beside you. If you're comfortable to close the eyes, close them down. Or you might just work towards that as you relax into these poses. So your head is to any side at this point. Inhale. And sigh your breath out. Gently feel yourself being supported by your bolster, supported by your props. And just observe where you are right now, checking in with your body, checking in with your breath. How are you feeling in your body, in your mind, right now on your mat? Are you able to observe these things without judgment, without pressure, without trying to change anything? Just simply observe where you're at, what you bring to your mat today. And with an in-breath and an out-breath, allow yourself to release any of the tension that might be whirling around in your mind. Just allow them to be. And as you practice, things might just settle on their own without having to do any work to change them, fix them. Just purely being supported by your bolster, by your props, by your yoga practice, you're able to do the internal work to find a better state or a calmer state of harmony. I'm just going to turn the head to the other side. Taking a deep breath in and a deep breath out. Slowly bringing the head back to center and making your way up onto your heels. So we're going to come into a melting heart pose, also known as half downward dog. So we'll bring the bolster to the front of our mat and we'll come onto the knees. Hips over the knees here, and without any props, this posture is just simply sliding the hands down and resting the forehead down. Using some props, you can use your bolster underneath your hands, And then you can rest the forehead onto a block. That's also a lovely option, providing a little bit more support and lift. It also gets a little deeper into the armpits, into the shoulders. So you can play around and see which one you like, which one feels good, which one feels like you're getting a nice release around the shoulders and the spine. The main thing to remember is that your hips and your knees are in line. So avoid sinking back, keep the lift. If you need to go deeper, you slide your hands down. So you've got plenty of room to come forward. Breathe in, breathe out. Do you feel like your arms are tired or it's too hard work? You can just rest the forearms down so there's less work onto the arms. But just keep that nice dropping of the armpit so you're still getting that stretch around the shoulders. Here, inhale, exhale, two more breaths, feeling the ribs expand as you breathe in, into your chest, and breathe out, bringing new and fresh life, prana into the body. Consciously breathing as you hold these postures. So we'll look up and we'll slowly make our way down onto the belly. Just bringing the arms, just stacking the arms over each other and just rest the head down. Just taking a breather here. We're going to move into our Sphinx pose. And Sphinx without any props is up on the forearms. The elbows are underneath the shoulders and the thumbs pointing towards each other. The shoulders relax and the head just drops a little and then you can close the eyes down. So you want to pull the shoulders away from the ears, relax the legs, relax the body, but we're still working by pressing slightly into the mat, dropping the shoulders down. So with props, this posture can be supported with a block. You can rest your head down onto a block, which makes it easier to hold for a longer period. And then the other option, which is very nice and supported, is bringing your bolster underneath the chest and the arms on top. So you're still having the arms exactly the same, except you've got more of a lift and support underneath the chest. And then you can use your block again for your head. Bringing the shoulders down away from the ears. Taking time to set the postures up so that you can feel like you're in the right space, you've got it right, and then you can rest. And once you're there, breathe in and breathe out. Opening here through the spine. we extend the back. Any tension in the body, the physical body around that area is released through this posture, but also any emotional tension around the heart, matters of the heart, things concerning you deeply. This posture is a nice one to open up, to create some space for love and for change. Harmony. Breathe in and you breathe out. Remind yourself that you are love. Love is your nature. You are love. You have the option here to come up with the chest and straighten the arms into your seal pose. So your hands are nice and wide. Your hands are turned out slightly. And you're pressing into your mat and lifting your chest, bringing those shoulders down so you're working into the spine a little more deeply. If it's too strong for you, come back down into Sphinx. If you're up, there are a few options. You can go stronger by bringing the hands closer to you and lifting up. If it's feeling too strong, too much work, bring the hands slightly forward. So there's a fine line that you have to work out for yourself. Where you're working, where you're feeling your edge, where the pose is just feeling great, nice and juicy in that pose. But you also don't want to be pushing it too hard where it's too hard work and there's pain. And you don't want it too easy where you just feel like you're doing nothing. So in a way, you've got to find that balance yourself because you know your body. So in this seal pose, you just work out the distance with your hands. And once you're there, just relax the head down. Relax the legs. And just relish in this pose. So we're opening through the thoracic spine, through the lower back, through the heart. Whenever we open the back, we open the heart. Allows us to create more space for love, more space for healing anything that's building, that's creating tension in our lives, anything that does not serve us that we want to release. We can always find more space for love because we are love. Love is our nature. And through our practice, we can try and tap into that and rediscover that. The essence of love. Bring your awareness to your breathing. Enjoy the silence of your breath. And slowly release the So you can get warm using your blanket or add some layers of clothing on. And then grab your eye bag if you've got one of those, or a little towel over the eyes. A little bit of pressure, withdrawing the senses. Take a moment to get comfortable. Feel relaxed in your body. And just open that heart center up to the sky, up to the universe, up to anything greater than yourself. And connect that love.